answer another question. So in my high school class, we just started a new chapter on why does God allow evil? Why is there so much pain and suffering? At the beginning, we went over and defined some terms. What is natural evil? What is moral evil? And this resulted into one question, one student turning in a question of, do I think that natural disasters are God's way of calling people to heaven? Now, there's a couple ways that this can be taken, so I'm going to address it in a few different ways. First, is it possible that God uses natural disasters as a form of showing his power? Yes, we see this in the book of Exodus, where God did the plagues in Egypt to show that he is greater than the gods that time. Is it possible that God uses natural disasters in a way to judge? And the answer is yes. We see this in the book throughout the Old Testament with the Israelites, where there were famines and where there was judgment and where the ground opened up and swallowed people whole. And God was clear that this was a form of judgment on the people. And he prophesied that through the prophets and spoke to the people those things. And so I absolutely think it's possible that God can use natural disasters as a way to show his power and to judge. However, I don't think that's necessarily true today. And the reason is God hasn't told us why each natural disaster happens. I'm sure there were disasters in the Israelite camps where fire broke out that wasn't an act of judgment on God. It was just someone lighting a fire and hurting some people. And so when it comes to today, will I say that an earthquake or a hurricane wipes out a country or city because God's act of judgment? No, I would not, because I don't know if that's actually true. God has not told us, I destroyed the city because they're evil. And so I'm not going to say God destroyed the city because they're evil, because I don't know if it's just an act of nature and we're just in a place where those things happen, or whether it's an act of God. So I'm going to stick with what I know. Now, what do I think natural disasters can do? What can we know from them? I don't think it's necessarily God killing us to take us to heaven because he needs us in heaven. As one student pointed out, you know, you sometimes hear in Hollywood, when a famous singer dies, well, God must have needed someone else singing up in heaven. That's not true. But here's what I think. The book of Revelation says that in the end times, there will be many natural disasters and famine and crazy things happening. And here's what I think we can know. Natural evil like sickness, disease, cancer, disasters like earthquakes and hurricanes and tsunamis, one thing they can do is remind us that we are not God, we are not immortal, and bad things happen. And we have to be thinking about death. What is going to happen to us at the point of death? I think if there was no natural evil, if there's no sickness, no cancer, no disease, no nothing, and no hurricanes or tsunamis or anything, then we might start to get this understanding like, hey, I'm immortal, I'm not going to die, and we stop thinking about that. The fact that I know that I can have a heart attack this very moment and die makes me prepared with things like life insurance and an understanding of who God is to know that I will be secure in my salvation. And so natural disasters, I think, are a powerful way, and natural evil, a powerful way to remind ourselves that our bodies are broken, that we will not live forever, that we are getting older, and we have to think critically about the things happening in life, because we don't know how long we're going to live. We can't just say, I'm going to wait till I'm 90, because not a lot of people make it to 90. We have to think critically about where we are going to be headed and think deeply about the things that are important in life, because we don't know what's going to happen next. And so I do think that natural disasters can cause us to recognize those things.